Now, even though the problem doesn't specifically ask you to, I'm going to take this problem just a step further to take these components of the force and turn it into vector notation, because you'll need to do that on some problems moving forward this semester. So since I have the x and the y components, I can express this force, again, on the first particle due to the second particle, as the x component, the minus 0.123 newtons, is in the i-hat direction, and then plus 0.33 newtons in the j-hat direction. Going one step further than this, remember that the force on particle 2 due to particle 1 is in the opposite direction, but it's still the same amount of force. And that means I can write down the force 2-1 by keeping the same components but flipping the signs. So where it was negative, it becomes positive, and where it was positive, it becomes negative. And that shows us that we have a positive x component and a negative y component. If you look back at the diagram, notice that positive x component and minus y component puts that arrow down into the fourth quadrant as we would expect. So even though it starts at a different place, we can still express the force in the same way as just the same force in the opposite direction.